Hello everybody, how are you? This is Andrea and today I have a new eye making video. Here I want to share with you a different material to use to make your eye bases. You're probably asking why would I want to use a different material from the one that I used in the past? And there is a specific reason and issue that this new material solves. So basically, the problem with using regular polyurethane resin for the base and then Liza Pavelka for the transparent section of the iris is that because Liza Pavelka needs UV light to set and harden, it can cause the bases to yellow quite a bit. Here is an example. The pair on the left is resin before I exposed it to the UV light. And this is after I used Liza Pavelka and cured it under UV light. You may think that the difference is not too bad, but believe me, the yellowish sclera looks a little bit odd in the doll. You may even encounter this issue where you're trying not to expose the base to the UV light for too long, but then the UV gloss doesn't cure all the way through, and then you get these kind of leaks around the edges. The yellowing won't be too noticeable on more peachy skin tones, tan colors, or fantasy colors. It is more of an issue and noticeable on very fair skin tones, and obviously white resin. Even so, I wanted to fix the issue, so I've been on the lookout for a while trying out different options. After some research, I found quite a few UV resin brands in white color. These are mostly used for craft projects like charm making, similar to Liza Pavelka. But as you can see, the problem was that the colors ended up a bit too translucent. I needed something more opaque and whiter in color. So I went back on the internet and learned that you can add specific pigments to UV resin to change the color and transparency levels. Here is an example of the UV resin. The one on the left is the way it looks originally, and the one on the right is when you add pigment to it. The exact product that I used for that is this Japanese white solid color for UV resin. I will leave all the links to the products in the description box. So let me show you how you use this material. Here we have the eye base molds, a little plastic dish, and the translucent samples as a reference. Okay, so on the left is the UV resin that I will use, and on the right is the UV pigment. Then I mix the two in the dish. First is the UV resin and then the UV pigment. Also, I am pretty sure that you don't need to use as much pigment as I did. A third of that should be more than enough. Mix it really well and then fill the molds. Remove any big bubbles with toothpick if they bother you, and then put it to set under your UV light of choice. How long it will take for the resin to set will depend on many factors, such as the power of your UV light and size of eyes, because the larger the volume, the longer it takes. I left mine in there for about 5 minutes. After the resin has hardened, you can easily take the bases out. And here are our new solid white resin eye bases. They are perfect. So yeah, now that you have your new eye bases, you can decorate them the same way as I've shown you in the previous episode of this series. I basically coat the iris section with Liquitex Matte Medium to make the surface more workable. Then I color it with my paints of choice. Optionally, you can add some glitter or iridescent flakes and then fill them with Liza Pavelka Magic Gloss. After which, set everything again under UV light. Here you can see the difference in color. The new UV resin with white pigment works like a charm and is honestly way easier to use and less messy than using regular polyurethane resin. So yeah, this is all I have for today. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, comment and share. Thank you so much for watching, take care, and I'll talk to you again next week. Bye!